thou bleeding beast of earth, but I am meek and gentle with thee. Thou art the ruins of the noblest man that ever lived in the tide of time. Woe to the hand that shed this costly blood. Over thy wounds now do I prophesy, which like dumb mouths do bear ruby lips, to beg the voice and utterance of my tongue. A curse shall light upon the limbs of men, domestic fury and fierce civil strife shall cumber all the paths of Italy. Blood and destruction shall be so in use, and dreadful objects so familiar, that mothers shall but smile when they behold their infants quartered with the hands of war, all pity choked with custom of fell deeds, and Caesar's spirit ranging for revenge with Ate by his side, come hot from hell, shall in these confines with a monarch's voice cry havoc and let flip the dogs of war, that this foul deed shall smell above the earth with carrion men groaning for burial. Hell, if thou see me down in battle, bestride me so. 'Tis a point of friendship. Oh, I would were bedtime hell, and all well.
Why, thou hast got a death.
He is not due yet. I'd be loath to pay him before his day. What need I be so forward with him that calls not on me? Well, 'tis no matter. Honor pricks me on. Yea, but how if honor pricks me off when I come on? How then? Can honor set to a leg? No. Or an arm? No. Or take away the grief of a wound? No. Honor hath no skill in surgery, then. No. What is honor? A word. What is that word, honor? Air. A trim reckoning. Who hath it? He that died a Wednesday. Doth he feel it? No. Doth he hear it?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.